right? A lot of women would claim the Most High. They would claim Yahusha, you know, they call Christ. But these women that claim to be women of the Most High, how come their heads don't be covered, Benai?
Good question.
Yeah, that's one of the requirements. A woman's, to show submission, a woman's head is supposed to be covered. And she's, what does the scripture say? If she's not covered, let her be shorn. I mean, bull-headed. Cut all of her head off, her hair off. So, you know, Eve starts to justify that by saying, well, God knows what's in my heart. See, that's when she starts lying. That's when you want to pick and choose what scriptures. 14 and 13. Second edges. 14 and 13. Justice Raheem, do you have an Apocrypha yet, good brother? Justice Raheem is here, but he's kind of not here. Probably the only one on the call that has Apocrypha is Benign.
Second edges 14, 13.
Yeah, Fernando, you got an Apocrypha?
Nah, I don't. Yeah. I just got the King James Version.
Yeah, the 1611?
No.
1611 had the Apocrypha in it.
Come on, I'll make sure to get one.
It's the book of Second Edges, chapter 14, verse 13. Now therefore, set thine house in order, and reprove thy people. Comfort such of them as be in trouble, and now renounce corruption.
So the Most High is giving men an order to set their house in order, which means a man is supposed to be the head of his household. He's supposed to be a ruler. What this society is pushing is equality. And so this is why the world is so chaotic today. Because that's not the order of the Most High. It's what Eve wants. But you got to remember, Eve's been trying to get where the man is since coming into existence. Because she made a covenant with High Shaitan. And unless that woman is moving in the right spirit, she has that same spirit of High Shaitan. Because she went against the Most High, man, for Satan to be like Adam. Let's get second edges. Let's jump down to verse 16 and 17. Huh? None of them other brothers got an Apocrypha. Yashabim, I said, I don't know what's going on with Yashabim. That's the boy, that's the brother four times that helped me with something, man, about putting this through, man. I'm not into the business of trying to make brothers, you know?
Come on. Yeah, that's crazy. You didn't ride yesterday, though.
Yeah.
It's the book of, Lock it, it's the book of 2 Edges, chapter 14. Verse 16, for yet greater evils than those which thou hast seen happen shall be done hereafter.
So the scriptures are saying all of the evil things that you've seen thus far, even greater evils are going to occur. And we're already seeing this stuff happen, man. I mean, you're going some things now, man. You have a third option about what sex you want to be. You guys realize that? Pretty soon, I haven't filled out a job application in a while, but pretty soon they're going to put their own job applications. And you're going to be able to check off other, you know, or some kind of different kind of sexual thing, you know?
I've seen it.
Yeah, because I'm seeing this pop up. They ask you, you're a male, female, or they have another option there now. From there, let's go to Sirach, Ecclesiastes 7 and 19. Hey, you guys could pull this up on the computer, you know. A good woman. This is what the scriptures say about a good woman. And what is a good woman? How will we identify one, Fernando? How do you know if you have a good woman? Just because she say, oh, I love you, baby. I love how you make me feel. Is that a good woman? Is that even love? Nope. It's emotional madness. Because when that feeling goes, this is what causes a lot of women to leave relationships. It's emotionally built. It's not based off of love. You guys do realize that some women get addicted to the honeymoon stage in a relationship. So she leaves relationship after relationship after relationship because she get a high off of that honeymoon stage. She like that feeling of newness. And when that wears off, she's gone with the wind. Huh? Whatever reason, is 75% of divorces executed by women. Huh? Talk back to me. Because once that feeling go away, she go away. She go with another man. And you know what this is? It's an abandonment issue. Comes from the childhood. Neglecting her childhood. Sirach, 7 and 19. Fernando, you still here? Let me pull up some of these precepts, man.
Huh. Yeah, I'm about to start typing it in.
Just look up KingJamesBibleOnline.org. You get the 1611 version.
You can put in Bible browse.
Book of Sirach, Ecclesiasticus, chapter 7, verse 19. Forgo not a wise and good woman, for her grace is above gold.
And so the scriptures say, don't forego a wise and good woman. A wise and good woman. Her grace is better than gold. Hey, Fernando, I'm going to post this link to an online Bible for you right there. Got the Apocrypha in it. If you click on that link, you can open it up. Just go right to the scriptures, man. I've been using that one for years.
Come on, I got it.
We got one again, Benay? What happened to justice, man? You went mute. Now it's no justice, it's just us.
He's asleep right now. He must be.
Ain't no way, he was just on.
It's, no, he ain't asleep, man. He's wide awake.
Somebody called on me, somebody called on the justice, man. What's happening?
You say that, man.
You want that precept again, up?
Yeah, go ahead. There's a link, Craig, right there to the Bible.
Come. Book of Sirach, Ecclesiasticus, chapter 7, verse 19. Forgo not a wise and good woman, for her grace is above gold.
Hey, Justice, what does he mean about forgo not a wise and good woman? What's meant by that? Hold on, we got someone coming on TikTok. Hopefully they're not coming with no semantics, huh?
Hiya.
Shalom.
It's Snoop Dogg.
These are grown women, huh? One of them. We'll see it later. One of them got leprosy. She got all blonde hair. Completely blonde. That doesn't even know why she's a leopard.
I don't know what the fuck he said. Who's a leopard?
Red as hell.
What's he doing?
Red as hell, man.
Who's a leopard?
Unclean.
Unclean. Unclean. Unclean.
Unclean?
What you want, Esau?
Huh?
What you want, Esau? What you want, Esau? The old lady in the background, you should know wisdom. You should be wiser than that. You act like a heathen.
What's the world context?
I can't believe that you got grown women. One of them is literally an old woman with gray hair. Turning white. And they're acting like just like the little children when they come on. One of them in the background, red, look like she, you know what I mean? You know how the dogs lay out? That's how she was laid out on the sofa. She's laid on the sofa like a canine. Like she was like an Edomite albino. No cat. All the way in the back. An Edomite albino.
Wow.
Wow. You really get some personalities on TikTok. For real. And just come on here laughing. One of them was overweight, and the other one was red as a damn lobster. Red as a damn lobster.
They just use it for attention. That's all a lot of TikTok is for.
I mean, I wouldn't anticipate adults behaving that way, man. Wow. So, let's get back to the scriptures, man. I always like to let them on, though, man, so people can feel the vibe and see where people are really at in life, man. Just gone, man. Gone.
Your TikTok lives, they stay safe on your TikTok account?
Well, they stay in the background for 30 days. You can't see them if it's over 10 minutes. I kept saying I was going to download them. I need to try and download them. That's what I'm going to do, man. Let me start downloading them. Now, upload them to YouTube. You know what I mean? You would see some buffoonery here.
Yeah, you can put that on the shorts.
No, it's too long for the shorts, man. Oh, you mean a little short portion with them?
Yeah.
Cut it up and do like making them look weird or whatever they do.
Yeah. You're right. That's a good idea, man. Put them on blast, man. Let me find these things, man. What are they hiding at? In the live studio? Yeah. I know they only last for 30 days, I read, man.
You should cut up the one where you helped
What was that?
She was getting bullied. The one where she was getting bullied. help save a person from bullying.
Come on.
See, like, help saves bullies.
Where's that live hub, man? These videos hide that. I read something before, man. It stays there 30 days. All right, let's get back to the scriptures, man. Let's go to Sirach 8:17-19. We're talking about a good woman. Scriptures say, forego not a wise and good woman. What is a wise and good woman? Because a lot of women would tell you, no, I believe in Christ and so on and so forth. According to the Bible, what is it? It's just live stuff, man. Where do these videos go? Live studio. Favorites. Settings.
It's the book of Ecclesiasticus. Sirach. Chapter 17. Chapter 8. Sirach, chapter 8, verse 17. Consult not with a fool, for he cannot keep counsel.
That's crystal clear, man. Consult not with a fool. He's not gonna be interested in your counsel, man. Where's these videos? It's a live hanging out at, man.
Verse 18. Do no secret thing before a stranger, for thou knowest not what he will bring forth.
Come on.
Verse 19, open not thine heart to every man.
See that?
Lest he requite thee with a shrewd turn. Lest he receive thee with a shrewd turn. It's the King James.
Come on. I'm curious. I could see those things on my arm. My phone when I go live? Let's see.
Out of here.
Just kidding. I haven't already said you don't want to have kids. I'm already at that point. I'm 34, so.
Yeah. But no kids. I have three. I'm good. They're golden. I have one in college, one in law.
Let's see that, man. Remember when there's lives hanging out of that? From there, let's go to Proverbs 12, verse 4. Talking about a good woman. I got to find these things, huh? Maybe I pull up that thing.
What's the science with Kadda? Anybody talk to him?
I sent him a text message earlier today, and he responded, but he didn't really say anything other than just what he responded.
I send a brother, you know what I'm saying? You know, I send everybody the group text, you know what I mean? Blessed day to you kings of Grand Rising. I mean, bro ain't hit back, but at least he responded back to you, so that's a blessing.
Kanye, he responded back to me about like a 4 or 5 hours ago.
You remember how to get those, Benaya? Tell me I gotta get them from the phone, man.
Probably from the phone.
See, man, it's gotta be another way. I haven't been using that studio thing, but I mean, there was an option to download them, man. I remember. What was I on? On my iPad? I don't like downloading stuff to Apple, man. It's space.
Yeah. You could save it locally and send it over to the desktop.
I don't necessarily know if you'll be able to like handle it.
I just don't know. There's gotta be some type of section.
Yeah, it's gotta be. Okay, release notes. They're saying that this thing, this studio got some kind of improvements or whatever, man. We'll see, but
how long has that been out? Because for them to restrict so many people from going live, I don't know if it's just a new thing or...
I haven't a clue, man. I haven't a clue.
Hmm. It would be a lot easier on there because you could just start it from there and you could do the stream yard all on one thing.
Yeah. What the heck is this stuff hiding out at, man? Okay, let's see, man. It's live studio again. It's gonna be installed again.
Not sin no more.
Okay, live center. This video is gotta be hiding somewhere, huh? Well, there they go. They're in this thing, man. She's in a prize. But the one that one I'm doing is not there. My downloader. Question is, how do you download them? Oh, there it is, right there.
Shalom and peace, once again. Kahuna Tells the Dog is live. Today we're going to talk about how to defeat almost any track.
Right, so that's one right there. Oh. It seems like I did more than three, man. I've done a lot of them, right? Unless I was on the other joint.
Shalom. There I go.
You getting them straight from the iPad? Is
that probably grammar? Nah, from the computer, from that studio place.
Yeah, it's way more than three. it's way more than three.
Yeah, it's only showing three. I've been going live like crazy times, man.
Welcome to another episode of The Truth. We'll make you mad. We'll make you mad indeed.
Yeah, something's not right, huh?
Might be on that iPad.
Nah, they should have been on here or something. It's just crazy. It's crazy, man. Okay, yeah, only three joints is showing up over here, man. Okay. Oh, I'm logged in. That might be why it's I'm logged into the different account. That was from the Taza Doctrine. Let me try and log into the other joint. Meanwhile, back to the precepts, man. Proverbs 12:4. Someone got that joint? Good woman. Proverbs 18:22. Justin, what Justin's doing, man? Justin just came in and say something about Godard, but he's not really saying nothing, man. What's up with the Justice, man? He's gone again.
Shalom, can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you, man. Come on, of course.
I made that comment like a few minutes ago, bro.
I know, but you haven't said anything when we was calling on you, man.
You had called Kadam?
No, we called you a few times, man, throughout the call since you've been on.
Oh. Just went mute. Yeah, but pardon me. I had muted the mic for a second. I had to went step away for a second. Slack your pardon.
Damn, what's the email?
But I'm here now in front of the mic. We good. You need me to answer something?
No, I don't even remember what I was asking now. Someone got that precept, man? Proverbs 18:22. I'm going to end this over here, man.
Got it up?
Hey, you said.